Okay, now the last retinacula. These are the peroneal or the fibular retinacula. Whenever we use the term peroneal, it means towards the lateral side. Therefore, we say peroneus longus and peroneus tertius. Peroneus brevis. They form the muscles of lateral compartment. Okay, so we know that fibula is also towards the lateral side. So peroneal or the fibular is related to lateral surface. So as you can see, this is the lateral aspect. Unlike this one, this was the medial aspect when I was talking about the flexor retinacula. Now I am going to talk about the peroneal or the fibular retinacula. So here you can see, this is the inferior extensor retinacula. This is the proximal and the distal limb. And this is the stem of the inferior extensor retinacula towards the lateral side. And here on the lateral surface, this is the calcaneum. This is the distal surface of fibula. You can say lateral malleolus is there. So superior fibular or the superior peroneal retinacula, it extends from the lateral malleolus to the lateral process of calcaneum. This is the superior fibular retinacula. Whereas the inferior extensor retinacula, it is continuous with the posterior fibers, or you can say simply, it is continuous with the stem of the inferior extensor retinacula. Okay, so this one is the superior fibular retinacula, this is the inferior fibular retinacula. Inferior fibular retinacula, it's continuous with the stem of inferior extensor retinacula. And as you can see, the muscles with the tendons which are being covered by this retinacula, these are peroneus brevis and the peroneus longus, or you can say fibularis brevis and the fibularis longus tendons. Okay, this is the common synovial sheath for both fibularis longus and fibularis brevis. So for now, you should know that inferior fibular retinacula, and it is continuous with the stem of inferior extensor retinacula. Both of these lie towards the lateral surface, and they are covering the tendons of peroneus longus and peroneus brevis.